Hi everyone, this is Dr. Rukmini Chaudhary and you are watching Dr. Rukmini's Health Update. My today's topic is thyroglossal duct cyst. So in this video, I'll be covering all about thyroglossal duct cyst. Like what is this cyst and how their, you know, diagnostic criteria, required test, basic test, you should go for a surgery. So you are requested to watch complete video for complete information. So let's begin. Thyroglossal duct cyst. Usually what happened, these are fluid filled sac. They are sac and they are fluid filled. Means they are soft, not hard, not that hard. So they are found usually in middle of your neck and just above your voice box. Right, so this is how. See, usually what happened, during embryonic development, fetus development in mother's, you know, womb, there is a thyroid gland and that is situated, you know, back of your tongue. See, the term thyro related with the thyroid gland, glossal related with your tongue and duct cyst, right? So this is how the term comes from this particular part. So normally during embryonic development, your thyroid gland, this is found just back of your tongue, and what happens normally during development, this comes down, descend down in your neck. Normally descend down from that part, there is a formation of duct. Through that, the thyroid gland passes down and that duct disappears gradually. So this is how it happens normally. But in some cases, that duct, that duct formed during the descending down of the thyroid gland, the duct doesn't disappear and it is found there, and there is a fluid accumulation over there, and this duct can, you know, convert into a cyst. So this is how thyroglossal duct cysts are formed. Symptoms and what difficulty you have when you have this problem. See, there is a no problem if it is a smaller in size. There is no problem at all. At times it goes unnoticed, not even a single size. It goes like asymptomatic, and if the size gets enlarged, size are bigger and they get, you know, enlarged with the time, then the symptoms can occur. And if it is infected, then you can have, you know, the tenderness, means you have that particular area painful to touch, and yes, there is a pain, tenderness, swelling is there in that case. So you have discomfort, like you have problem while breathing, difficult breathing you have, and even difficult speech you have, like you have hoarseness of voice and difficult swallowing. You have dysphagia due to that enlarged lump, and there's a lumpy feeling in the center of your neck, just middle of your neck. These cysts are usually congenital, means they are childbirth, and at times they usually diagnose like in preschool children, middle of your adolescence. These are plastic part. What and how it is diagnosed, See, the diagnosis is usually made by the USG, neck USG, and like USG, MRI, CT scan. These tests can be done, and FNAC to rule out cancer, because this is a lump and there can be a fear that you might have cancer. So for ruling out that cancer part, your FNAC can be done, and thyroid blood test. Thyroid test should be done. You know, there is an idea that how your thyroid is working, your thyroid gland is working. For that purpose, thyroid test are done. And let's talk about the treatment part, what treatment required and what treatment in what cases. So it is like that. See, if the cyst is smaller in size and you don't have any symptoms, so there is no treatment required. If this is growing, so in these cases you can have different symptoms, and in homeopathy your symptoms matters a lot. There is a concept in homeopathy, holistic, means what all totality of your symptom, what all symptom you are having, we should consider all your symptom, like what difficulty you have, whether you have difficult breathing or difficult swallowing, you have pain, tenderness, consider all these things. And individualization means particular, what is peculiar about your case, you're obese or you are thin. So all these are very important keynotes. These are very important features for a medicine and for a patient as well. Dromium is a very effective medicine. You can take dromium when you have, like you have hoarseness of voice, difficult voice problem, you have speech problem, and dromium is given in all respiratory problem, like whether you have asthma, you have bronchitis, you have diphtheria, even there is a throat problem. So, and in thyroid disorder as well, so dromium is given in even goiter. So in thyroglossal duct cyst, if you have, you know, speech problem, difficult breathing, and inspiration is very difficult, when you inhale there is always a problem, so in that case you can use dromium. If you are watching on YouTube, I have provided all medicines link, on the description box. You can buy medicine from there. But before buying, just watch complete video, at least medicine, that you have idea this medicine is given in these symptoms. Never ever mix all the medicines. Don't buy all the medicine. Just watch complete video and buy according to your case. So bromelain 30 or 200 potency and have medicine 1 or 2 drops direct on tongue, or just have before meal like 30 minutes. See, phosphorus is given in cylindrical constitutions. I told in initial that if it matters a lot in homeopathy, whether you are obese, whether you are cylinder, whether you are length in a personality. So in that case, if you get tired easily, you catch a cold easily, and you are, you know, restless, in that wonder. And tubercular diathesis, right? There's a glandular problem. So you can use phosphorus again in 30 or 200 potency, 1 or 2 drops twice or thrice. In this way, you can have this belladonna. See, belladonna is common in all respiratory trouble, throat trouble, congestion, headache, migraine, and even in cystic problem as well. So once you have cyst, there is a redness, inflammation, and if you have severe pain, there's a tenderness. So in that case, you can use belladonna again in 30 or 200 potency, 1 or 2 drops twice or thrice. This way, Atosta, a very good medicine. Spongia again given in all thyroid problem, thyroid abnormalities. Spongia is given when you have excessive dry, there is an excessive dryness and difficult swallowing, you have problem, you have dysphagia, there is a difficulty in swallow, and you have dryness, excessive difficult breathing. So these are, that is covered by the spongia. There are other medicine like thyroidinum, iodum, and so homeopathy medicine always, you know, selected by the patient's symptom, totality of symptoms. And what about allopathy part of treatment? See, if these cysts are larger in size, bigger in size, and they are causing trouble for you, like they are very painful and they are bothering you on daily basis, so in that case you are having larger and bigger, you can go for a surgery. So if you find this video knowledgeable, informative, you can like, share, and press the bell icon to get notified. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching. Thank you so much. Thank you. Keep watching. Thank you.